Hi everyone, this is Ben with TeensandTech.com, and I'm bringing you part two in our series, Privacy Settings for Social Media. And today we're going to talk about Facebook and what privacy settings inside of Facebook looks like. Now there's three things I want to cover with privacy settings for Facebook. The first one is who can see your teens' stuff in regards to future posts as they share photos and status updates, stuff like that. The second is who can contact your teen via who can send them friend requests or who can contact them in the messages, the private messaging tool within Facebook. And then who can look your teen up either by email, phone number, but also search engines, Google, Facebook, search engines, stuff like that. So we're going to cover all three of those today. So if you look on the screen, you'll see my Facebook profile. When I log in, this is the first thing that I see. It's my timeline. Now the what's on your mind status bar shows you, I can type, hello, my name is Ben. I won't share that, but, I can actually post something. Now this drop down right here shows me who my default is and who the status is going to be shared with. So I have it set to my friends. Now let's jump in how to do that and set that default. On this lock right here with the three lines, this is the quickest way to get to the privacy settings. If you click on that, it's going to drop down and have automatic, you know, really quick links. But I'm going to click on see more settings, and it just brings me to all of my settings for privacy within Facebook. So I showed you how the drop down, my statuses are defaulted to friends, only sharing that with friends. And that's right here. Who can see future posts? You can edit that to say public, which shares it with the world, friends accept acquaintances, only me, custom, stuff like that. I have it set to friends, so whenever I post, all my friends can see what I'm posting. Within each individual post, you can change that option, but if you set the default every time, you don't have to worry about changing it. It's going to automatically share with my friends. Now, the rest of the options under who can see my stuff, review all your posts and things you're tagged in. You can review everything that you've ever posted, everything that you've ever tagged in, stuff like that. Let's go back into the privacy settings. And then also limit the audience for posts you've shared with friends of friends or public. And you can do that if you choose. I think the most important thing is deciding who sees your posts when you post them and who sees your teens' posts. The next thing is who can contact me, who can send you friend requests. I have it set to everyone. Now you can change that to friends of friends so that it's not just strangers out there, but you have to actually get almost kind of like an introduction. It won't be just the general public. I would say for teens, I highly recommend clicking friends of friends on this. I have it set to everyone just because I am an adult and I know a lot of people outside of my own personal friends networks that I want to be able to contact with. So that's set to everyone, and I can discern when somebody sends me a friend request, I can say no or yes to that. But as a teen, I would say I recommend setting that to friends of friends. That way it's only within a certain network. Whose messages do I want filtered in my inbox? As a teen, again, I would set that to strict because it's going to be mostly messages from friends and stuff like that. It's not going to be from strangers because if you set it to basic filtering, it's mostly friends and people you may know. But strict actually closes that off even more so. Now, the most important part, I think, is who can look your teen up. And that's this last option here. So if you see here, who can look you up using the email address or phone number you provided. I have everyone. You can set that to friends of friends. You can set that to only friends. Only friends is obviously the most high security you can have it because it won't be strangers or anything like that. It's only people that you've searched for yourself or your teen has searched for themselves and friend requested, and then now they've allowed them to contact with them. The last one is, do you want other search engines to link to your timeline? Now, this includes multiple different search engines, Google, the search within Facebook, other stuff like that. For teens, again, I recommend unchecking that because now nobody can just search and stumble across your profile via Google search or Facebook search. If it's unchecked, that means the profile is unsearchable. And the only people who can friend you and stuff like that is people you choose or your teen chooses. So unchecking that gives you the highest security within Facebook and within the entire internet and what the internet has on your Facebook profile. So make sure your teen has that unchecked. That's what I would recommend. This is the primary really basic security settings for Facebook. There's a couple of other options that I would love to hear from you. If you have questions about other things like that, put them in the comments. That would be great. And I can answer them because there's a lot of other stuff you can do on Facebook and stuff like that. But these three things, who can see your teen stuff, who can contact your teen, and who can look your teen up, I would say are the most important things to worry about. And you have them right here in this video. If this was helpful, please like this video and subscribe so that you can get more in this series and future series as well. Again, my name's Ben with TeensandTech.com. Thank you so much for watching.